Have we gotten any updates on the Arkansas measure? It seems like that those should be coming in, but I haven't heard anything about this yet.
Also,
yeah,
Russ?
Jennifer, I can give you a little bit of update there, Jennifer. Checking out the results that are being posted on CNN.com on Arkansas Issue 5, the medical marijuana initiative, with 61% of the vote counted, it's still sitting at 48% support. So not promising for Arkansas medical marijuana, but really, when you consider that we're talking about the first southern state to ever vote on this, I think 48% is a moral victory.
Definitely, definitely. And with only 60% of the vote in, that is still rather close. It's not completely called yet, but it's not looking good. But yeah, that's a huge win for the first southern state to be considering this issue.
There are some southeastern border counties in Arkansas that have yet to be counted. I don't know my geography that well of Arkansas, but I'm imagining those might be some more urban areas. So we'll see if that number gets pushed up any. The latest results I've seen on Oregon's Measure 80 has kept it at 45% last I was checking, and the only counties so far passing Measure 80 are Multnomah County, which is where Portland is located, of course, and then Lincoln County, which is it's on the Oregon coast, central Oregon coast. It's the home of the casino there in Lincoln City. So far, the only two counties in Oregon that seem to be passing Measure 80. Looking at I-502 in Washington, it has passed. The news organizations are calling it for I-502 passing. Looking at a county-by-county results, for those of us in the Portland area, we might be interested on how Clark County turned out. That's Vancouver, Washington. And it's a 50-50 split in Vancouver, Washington for support of legalization. Luckily, that law passes no matter what Clark County says. And Iva, we're going to be driving across the river and enjoying some 502 stores in the future.
Honey, I'm going to be driving across the river tonight. I don't know in what vehicle I am going across the river tonight, and I'm going to enjoy. Oh, I shouldn't say that on the air, should I? I just realized we haven't got our legalization here in Oregon yet.
Don't forget, Washington has that driving under the influence privilege, so you need to get a hotel and crash there for the night.
That's right.
I do want to point out something really quick on those Oregon numbers, though. I mean, even if people are getting a little discouraged seeing that, you know, with only 45% approval, let me just point out that when we voted on marijuana dispensaries only 2 years ago, it was pretty close to that number. I want to say that it concluded with 46% support. So to have 45% of Oregonians saying, yes, we should legalize marijuana, that is a message for our legislature. That is a message for Oregonians. That means that we're getting the same. I said when we failed with the dispensaries that I believe that there was more support for legalization because the question of medical marijuana is creating kind of a quasi-legal under this prohibition umbrella, which does
loopholes.
Create conflict.
Right.
If we just would legalize it for all adults, it removes all of that conflict immediately.
Right.
And most people recognize that. And I think that's what we're seeing here in Oregon, that even if we don't pass it, that we are looking for something better than medical marijuana towards legalization.
Hey, Russ, are you still on?
Yes, yes.
Russ, so you know what this means,
don't
you? You know what this means, and this is just, you know, for anybody who knows, Russ and I, every year we go to, we go camping on the 4th of July in Washington, and my family brings out their coolers of beer. Do you know what this means, Russ? This means I'm going to sit around the fireplace. That's right, with my joint, and if I get any lip, I'm going to say, it's perfectly legal. Bite me.
Yeah.
I am not going to hide in the bushes anymore. I will not hide in the bushes anymore. This is it. I am not doing anything wrong to my body or to anybody else, and I'm sure as hell not going to share my joint with my underage nieces and nephews. I'm going to enjoy it and the freedom that I have in Washington. I cannot wait for that moment.
Yes.
It's going to be a good one. I do want to get an update on another state that we've been covering here, the state of Montana. Of course, Montana's been dealing with the fact that they had their medical marijuana law was repealed outright by the legislature. The governor saved it with a veto, and then the legislature came back with a bill called SB 423, which is we call it repeal light, because it pretty much destroyed most of the medical marijuana industry out there in Montana. Our own Heather Morris is out there in Montana. She's with Montana Normal. She's one of the co-founders of Montana Normal. Latest results I've got show 41% vote, what we need, a no vote, still only 13% results in. So, Heather, do you have any updates for us?
No, you're about right. And actually, I mean, the numbers, the percentages aren't changing that much. You know, we're roughly staying at that 42% against, which is what we were hoping for. But again, it's still quite early, so we're not giving up hope.
All right. Thank you, Heather, for standing by for us. And again, we've been talking about Oregon's Measure 80. There's still six or seven counties where they're counting votes. We're going to go to Herb Thrasher, who's hanging out at the world-famous Cannabis Cafe, along with somebody in a bear's hat. What's up with that?
That's right, man. We've got freaking Chicago Bears coach right here. No, we got Iko, man. Dude, this guy, you guys need to know that, I mean, how much work he put into Okta, which became Measure 80, and how much he does for Russ's and my the Herb Thrasher Flower Hour show, the network, and just everything all around guy. Iko right here, man. I appreciate everything he does. But we are sitting here. We're in the cafe still, and I have...
Oh, no.
...out of our balloon here in Oregon. We've half of us are starting to admit that we might not win this thing, and half of us are still holding hope. We're hearing the numbers, and Russ, we're seeing the same numbers that you're reporting, so it really does not look good. We really needed Multnomah County to almost double, and it's just not really going to do it for us. As you mentioned, Vancouver is telling, 50-50 right there, so close to Portland, and so we're just we're hanging tight, you know, a little bit of hope left, but we're not feeling it. But then again, we're definitely celebrating Colorado and Washington as we understand that this is a national feat tonight, and we're just part of the national team here in Oregon. We just happen to be representing Measure 80 tonight. And Zerb Thrasher with Iko here at the World Famous Cannabis Cafe. Appreciate High Time supporting everything. And Russ, back to you, dude.
All right. Thanks, Zerb Thrasher. And thanks, Iko, for all the work you guys are doing out there.
Sounds like
we're having
got
a lot of news coming in here from I-502. They're making some announcements. We're going to go over to Rick Thompson, who's in Michigan. Got some big news from Michigan. Let's switch over to Rick.
All right. Hi, thanks very much for kicking it over to me so quickly. We have fantastic news here in Michigan. As we've been announcing all night long, we've got five local ballot initiatives in the state. As of right now, all five are winning, and in fact, we've actually been able to call one of those battles already. Oh, in Ypsilanti, they've passed their lowest law enforcement priority by a staggering 79.2% margin.
Oh, my gosh! That's
that was where?
Lead has improved from 57 to 60% for. Detroit still remains solid at 65%, but we have a greater number of precincts reporting. We also have Flint standing stall at 57%, and Kalamazoo has a 5,000 to 2,000 vote margin over their opponents. So that's winning as well. And in fact, sitting right next to me is Matt Abel, the Cannabis Council, from the name Cannabis Council, in the building that we're here. Matt's the lead legal eagle on the entire Proposal M adventure, and he's one of the primaries responsible for having this passed this evening, or at least for what looks like it's going to pass this evening. We don't jinx anything in Michigan. We know how that goes. But fantastic news here, Ross. And on top of Washington announcing legalization and Colorado announcing legalization, I think we're looking at a fantastic evening for the United States of America.
I couldn't concur more. This is so exciting. It's a big night for the marijuana activists. It's a big night for the marijuana community.
It's history in the making.
It's history. It's more than it's freedom for so many people. I still can't, you know, shake the sadness that there are so many people that should be here today celebrating this. This should have been done, you know, a long time ago.
We lost Renee Emery Wolf this year, and many of you know that Renee Emery Wolf has a memorial, an award named for her at National Normal. And in fact, Matt Abel can tell you a little bit about National Normal. He's the executive director of our Michigan chapter of Normal as well.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for having me on the podcast.
You're welcome. Thank you for doing everything that you do. Keep up the good fight. We still have many more states to win. But, you know, thank you for everything that you've done and what you've brought to the state of Michigan. So many more people are going to be saved because of cannabis. We're going to have jobs for people. We've created a change in in politics. Today is a huge, huge day.
Yeah, it is. It's a great day here in Detroit. We're looking to have an extremely successful local proposal. Everything in Michigan is passing, so...
All right, well, we're going to take a quick break. We're going to celebrate off-air for a minute, and we'll be checking back with everybody in just a few minutes. Thanks so much. You're listening to Marijuana Election Night 2012.
Celebrating the mayor.
You're listening to Marijuana Election Night 2012 coverage on RadicalRust.com. Brought to you by the Russ Belville Show VIP members and High Times Magazine, TheWeedBlog.com, the law offices of Omar Figueroa, the National Cannabis Coalition, MikeCan.net, California Normal, Montana Normal, and the Medical Marijuana Radio Show.
Hi, this is Melissa Etheridge, and I'm encouraging you to vote yes on Amendment 64. Because a few years ago, I was going through cancer chemotherapy, and I was suffering. The nausea, the pain, it was terrible. Prescription drugs were not helping. The only thing that allowed me to function and regain my strength was marijuana, and I'm grateful for the relief it provided me. You know, before I needed to use marijuana, I just accepted the laws that treat marijuana users as criminals. But it's funny how a serious illness can give you a new outlook on life. I now see that it's wrong to arrest adults for using marijuana, and it's even more wrong to allow gangs and cartels to profit from selling marijuana. Instead, we should allow adults to possess limited amounts of marijuana, and we should regulate marijuana sales in order to generate tax revenues for public school construction and other community needs. To me, regulating marijuana is simply the right thing to do. Please vote yes on Amendment 64, paid for by the campaign to regulate marijuana like
Which of you are ready to admit to having used marijuana in the past? And they want us to go around and ask each of you. Senator Karri? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Senator Edwards?
Yes.
Senator Lieber?
I have a reputation for giving unpopular answers at Democratic debates. I never used marijuana. Sorry.
I think you'd probably be a lot cooler if you had, Senator.
Smoke a little pot, drink a little wine. Everything will be just fine. Smoke a little pot, drink a little wine. Everything will be just fine.
Well, I guess we're back. You're listening to Marijuana Election Night 2012. Man, what an exciting night. So much good news across the country. Even if... you know, not all the measures pass. We've made a huge, huge impact. Crack is in the wall, and it's tumbling down.
Tear down that wall, you know, I don't want Oregon to be all down. I mean, I know there's a lot of people listening right now here in Oregon that are getting a little depressed to see that we didn't get to join, you know, the other two. It looks like. It's not official yet, but with marijuana. But I want to say that we've won in a lot of other places. I'm looking at some of the results, and I know Brad Avakian is running for the Bureau of Labor and Industries.
It looks like Rick Steves is speaking, and we need to cut over to Russ.
Yeah, let's go to him.
Let's go to Russ. Russ.
Russ?
Yes, we got Rick Steves speaking. I'm trying to get the mic out to you.
Oh, gotcha.
Touched this 10 years ago, and
prohibition one state at a time. That's how they did it 8 years ago.
Seattle City Attorney Pete Holmes is speaking for him, Rick Steves. I know probably with the mic you couldn't hear it very well, but just want to give you a feel for the room here. People are excited. Rick Steves mentioned that the world will wake up tomorrow and they will realize we have begun the end of prohibition. And he mentioned how 80 years ago when we took apart alcohol prohibition, it happened state by state. And that's how we're doing it here with marijuana prohibition, state by state. Let me throw back to the studio at Portland, Oregon.
All right.
It looks like Multnomah County has got 48% of the votes in. 48% of the votes in. 58% are yes and 42% are no. But that's only half the votes are counted in Multnomah County. Still got our fingers crossed. There's still many counties trying to get counted and get their numbers in. I am not going to give up hope. I am keeping my fingers crossed. Maybe I'm being too optimistic, but I feel like the energy is going our way.
I think it's going to happen. I'm still with it.
I'm still seeing Multnomah with less than half the votes in and 58%, and that is a good number. That is a really good number, and we still have many, many more counties to count. So keep your fingers crossed. Still keep sending those good vibes our way, and those numbers get pushed up. Because we need another state that has legalization. We have our medical marijuana. Now it is time to bring about the end of prohibition.
All right. And, in that vein, we've got a great classic track here that was requested by Russ. He said, go ahead and play that song. Might as well. This is Peter Tosh with Legalize It. Everybody enjoy.
Don't criticize it. Legalize it, yeah, yeah, and I will advertise it. Some call it of instrument too. Legalize it, yeah, yeah, that's the best thing you can do. Doctors smoking,
don't criticize it. Legalize it, yeah, yeah, and I will advertise it. It's good for the food. For asthma, good for tuberculosis, even pneumothrombosis. Got to legalize it. Don't criticize it. Advertise it. Birds eat it. Ants love it. Fowls eat it. Goats love to play. Legalize it, yeah, yeah, and I will advertise it.
So we're back here with Marijuana Election Night 2012 coverage. I feel like every time we come back, we just have to say we've legalized marijuana in two states. Colorado and Washington both have legal marijuana for adults.
Yes, indeed, people. We are not joking. This is not the Twilight Zone. You are not standing on your head. Marijuana is legal in two states.
And then we've added to the medical marijuana states. Massachusetts passed pretty overwhelmingly their question three. We've had some very overwhelming results in Michigan that we were reporting on a little while ago, in various local counties where they're voting on decriminalization and low-level priority, things like that.
Huge passes.
Ypsilanti, however you say that, 79.2% approved, making it the lowest level priority.
Beautiful.
That's huge. But I was saying right before we cut over a minute ago, and I just want to point this out for Oregonians, that not all is lost. Brad Avakian is running for the Commission for the Bureau of Labor, and he vowed to defend medical marijuana patients' rights, you know, in the workplace and all that, that he was upset by the decision in Emerald
You're
Steel.
You're listening to Marijuana
These are some big
Election
wins
Night
that we still had, so we'll be right back.
RadicalRust.com, brought to you by the Russ Belville Show VIP members and High Times Magazine. TheWeedBlog.com, the law offices of Omar Figueroa, the National Cannabis Coalition, MikeCan.net, California Normal, Montana Normal, and the Medical Marijuana Radio Show.
Is on the Oregon ballot this November. I'm just one of over 500,000 Oregon adults who use marijuana annually, and I'm asking you to vote yes on Measure 80. Measure 80 would finally end the futile prohibition of marijuana and institute regulations that treat marijuana like alcohol. Measure 80 would end the facade of police trying to determine who is sick or healthy enough to put in a cage over a plant. Measure 80 provides jobs and tax revenue that Oregon desperately needs and institutes the industrial hemp crop our legislators already legalized. Best of all, Measure 80 protects our children by imposing the same educational and ID carding requirements that have brought teen alcohol drinking and tobacco smoking to their lowest ever recorded levels. Marijuana smokers are your family, your coworkers, and your friends, and we are one out of every seven Oregon adults who deserve the same respect as our friends who enjoy fine Oregon wines and craft beers. We may be the only Oregonians who want to pay more taxes. Please donate to Oregonians for Law Reform at OregonLawReform.com and help us help Oregon by passing Measure 80.
Michael Phelps, Olympic superstar, 14 gold medals, world record holder. So much for that amotivational syndrome.
Welcome back. You're listening to Marijuana Election Night 2012. I don't know how long this goes, and it's all set on auto at the moment.
It's kind of groovy. I like it. I like this background music because it kind of sets the mood for all the excitement that's going on tonight. Yep.
Jesse.
Oh,
okay, hey. So Washington and Colorado have legalized, so we're celebrating in two states right
yes,
now.
Yes, we are. Our neighbors to the north. Yay, I'm so proud of you people. Colorado, I know there's a huge celebration going on there because they were the first state to legalize in the country. And you know what? Who cares? Who cares? It's fucking legal in Colorado and Washington. I've got goosebumps all night long. You know, there's still some states that we haven't reported on. Montana, 16, according to CNN.com. 16% of the vote is in, 59 is voting to voting against them, and then 41% is in their favor. So it looks like Montana so far is not doing well. Detroit, Michigan, like we were mentioning earlier, has had an amazing night.
And then I keep getting cut off, so let me just throw this in there.
Okay,
really quick.
Go ahead.
Brad Avakian, labor commissioner. Okay. This one's important, and the reason it's important on a local level is because Bruce Starr is the guy that his opponent is the guy that wanted to drug test all welfare and food stamp and unemployment recipients, and he wanted to. To, despite the flaws with this whole policy. And then he wanted to overturn medical marijuana. He's opposed to everything medical. And Brad Avakian is beating him. As a labor commissioner, the fact that he defends the working rights of medical marijuana patients, that's a good win there. You know, that's somebody that we want in that office. That's somebody that we want to continue to defend our rights. We've also got Ellen Rosenblum, who won the primaries with the help of a medical marijuana community here in Oregon. And she won. She's been acting as interim attorney general since John Kroger stepped down to take a different position after the primary.
Right.
So I think we were probably all expecting her to win, but it's looking like she's won by overwhelming numbers. Mm-hmm. I think it was 56-57%.
And for those listening nationally, that was a huge race that the cannabis community got behind and really put some pressure and I influenced that race. I really believe that race was won because we got behind her and said, hey, we want someone to look out for us.
Yeah. And I think as Attorney General, she has a lot of potential power for our arguments here in Oregon, you know, so.
Well, and we you know, as in all elected officials that we have, you know, got behind, I hope that she stays true to her word and continues to support us. I don't have evidence of that yet.
I was going to say, I think that she sounds very promising towards our goals right now. She has opportunity to show us.
To demonstrate that to us. For sure.
One of the things that she ran for, I mean, it's not medical marijuana or marijuana in general that she's running for. It's patients' protection, patients' rights, protecting our children. Mm. She, at least as it's been explained so far, she kind of sees the connection in all of those that this medical marijuana ultimately is where we are protecting our children, protecting our patients, mm-hmm. protecting our elderly. And so at least having that glimpse, I don't think you can unsee that.
Right, right.
Okay. And I think we got Russ back with us in Seattle. Let's go ahead and switch back over to him now. Russ, you with us?
Yes, Michael Russ back here at I-5 headquarters here in, well, not headquarters, but the party here in Seattle. Starting to die down. You know, marijuana has been legalized here in the state of Washington, so people are now starting to head out and go out to the parties to celebrate that victory. We do have want to catch you up on a few other news items, some results that
we hadn't gotten any information on before, but we now have some results for you. In the state of California, they have a Prop 36, which isn't a marijuana thing, but it's a three-strikes prison reform.
Oh, yeah.
And the way I like to call it, I like to say that your third strike has to can't be a foul ball. You have to actually get a violent felony for your third strike. That's the reform that they're trying to pass. With 16% of the vote in, 68% of Californians are supporting three strikes reform. So that's good for our people, because a lot of times the third strike ends up being somebody smoking a joint when they're on probation or something. So that will help some cannabis consumers. We spoke earlier tonight to Rudy Reyes, the medical marijuana activist who is running for mayor of Santee, California, which is a suburb of San Diego. Unfortunately, with most of the votes counted there, Rudy Reyes has only garnered 19% of the vote. But, hey, we're talking about grassroots activism, a totally unknown figure in politics, and he gets 1 out of 5 votes in a conservative San Diego suburb. That's a moral victory for sure. Also, looking through Michigan, Rick Thompson reported to us earlier from the Medical Marijuana Show that Kalamazoo, Michigan, passed its medical marijuana zoning for its dispensaries. A good bill there that they passed with 67% of the vote. 2 out of 3 people in Kalamazoo supporting the expansion of medical marijuana dispensaries. Flint, Michigan, passed decriminalization of marijuana in the city with a 57% yes vote. Detroit passes decriminalization with a 65% yes vote. Grand Rapids, Michigan, passes decriminalization with a 60% vote. And Ypsilanti, Michigan, passes lowest law enforcement priority with a staggering 79% of the vote. Now, in sadder news, I got a note from the Oregonian, the state's largest newspaper, is calling the Measure 80 election, saying that Measure 80 has failed in the state of Oregon, according to the Oregonian's projections. However, with Washington and Colorado passing legal marijuana, we know come 2014, Oregon is going to join them. Let's head back to Portland, Oregon, and RoLLaJaY Studios crew.
What an exciting night. What an exciting night.
That's a lot of big news, but yeah.
Even the bad news is not bad news. A loss is not a loss. We have really made change in this country. It's been a good night for us in this community. We can see the ball moving forward. We see people, celebrating, and I'm celebrating for them. This is a huge night. A loss is not a loss tonight. It's still a win.
Yeah, and just because the Oregonians said so, I don't know. I think that they still need to count everything.
You were talking about that earlier, Jennifer.
I want to recount.
I don't trust the Oregonian. It's
they weren't for it anyway.
I would have to go on a total rant to explain why I don't trust them, but let's just say that they have actively lobbied against Measure 80 since they started reporting on it. They've definitely tried to call this race since before it started, and I think that they've continued to try to call it as these election results come in. And I think that it's not looking favorable now. Even a broke clock is right twice a day.
And CNN's calling the poll for the projected winner is no. But again, only 48% of the votes are in.
I think we have a lot of votes to count.
There's still a lot to count.
And I think I would point out again, with our last election, here in Oregon, multiple news agencies had called our governor results and had claimed that the Republican candidate, and his name slips my mind at the moment, but, that he had won and that it was a done deal. And they were reporting it across the board. And as late as 2 days later, they were still trying to correct it because the Democratic candidate won.
They're like, sorry. And I hope that's how it goes.
And I'll tell
cannabis.
You.
Oh, no, it didn't pass. Oh,
well,
wait, yeah, it did.
There's a very easy reason why this happens. Multnomah County, being the largest by far county in Oregon, tends to be one of the latest turn-ins because it's so easy to turn in your ballot here. You can do it at 7:59. Mm-hmm. When you're in the rural areas, they're getting them in earlier by mail and things like that. So we tend to be the last county counted. Yeah. But we also are a great majority of the population in this state and tend to be very, very, very liberal. Even currently, it's,
I think we're going to surprise. We're going to surprise ourselves yet.
Well, I still think it's 45. There's a 10% difference, you know, between, but I still think that's not bad because we had originally projected not that long ago that it was going to be in the 30s.
Let's jump over to Herb Thrasher at the Cannabis Cafe. Yep. A lot of the agencies are calling Measure 80 a loss, so we want to get some reactions and thoughts from what you guys are hearing and thinking over there. Herb, you here with us?
You got a soft mute, Herb, there?
We're trying to get Herb
hey,
on the...
guys.
There
yeah,
you are.
Here and, yeah, you know, the boat's sailing a little slower right now, I have to admit. We're hanging in there. Like I said, man, half are still kind of holding out hope and half are have given in. We're all appreciative of Colorado and Washington, and the numbers of people are still here, so we're still... fired up, man. We're still supporting that. We're celebrating that. It definitely looks like, you know, Oregon's probably going to have to move on. And I'll tell you, in there talking with people and hearing some of the talking there now, we're already talking about what's Oregon's step, you know, legislator. You know, it definitely, I can guarantee you that this Measure 80 team and that everybody who threw in that has worked hard over the last 4 or 5 years, I guarantee you that we're not going to give up. Washington is definitely going to help this area. You guys have been hearing Iva and some of the locals talk. I mean, it's right across the bridge. So, I mean, we definitely have hope for the future, but we'll see.
Scott, you were mentioning earlier about the legislature. Don't you think now that Washington is legalized and Colorado's legalized and 80 is not going down in flames, by the way. It may not win, but it is not going down in flames. So don't you think that measure, you know, pass the passage of Washington and Colorado don't you think that that's going to put pressure on the legislature to do something? Because they always talk about this, you know, the border, you know, cannabis going back and forth. Now is their opportunity to step up and change that if they really want to. Their neighbors to the north have decided that this is a good thing for the state of Washington. So don't you feel that there'd be some pressure on them to come up with something that works?
Yeah, I do. And that's kind of what I'm alluding to, you know, as far as this Washington is just... it's going to help, period. You know, Oregon, probably more states than any because we're border right here. It is going to put pressure.
Right.
But you guys got it, too, that this Measure 80 team, we kind of, you know, there's a plan B. And as far as they have been talking to some of the Oregon representatives here, and there's already, you know, Peter Buckley, you know, he there's just some talk. And so
there's
some possibilities,
there's
some avenues, way to go. And I can guarantee you that we're definitely not going to give up here in Oregon.
And, all right. Well,
and I just wanted to say, you know, I mean, the one thing to point out I mentioned earlier, that this is almost a matching vote to dispensaries. So this is that's a huge statement that Oregonians are making right now.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so we got to take a quick break. We'll be back right after this quick break.
There's just all kinds of factors to it. But we do need to celebrate Colorado and Washington tonight, and that's what we need to put our positive vibes and energy towards.
You're listening to Marijuana
Election
Night 2012 coverage on RadicalRust.com. Brought to you by the Russ Belville Show VIP members and High Times Magazine, TheWeedBlog.com, the law offices of Omar Figueroa, the National Cannabis Coalition, MikeCan.net, California Normal, Montana Normal, and the Medical Marijuana Radio Show.
Did you know that 1 out of 7 Oregon adults will use marijuana this year? Did you know that only 1 out of 10 Oregon marijuana consumers are medical marijuana patients? That's over 500,000 Oregon adults participating in the marijuana market. And the state of Oregon sees not one dime of tax revenue or job growth from the uncounted millions spent on marijuana. Isn't it time we regulated the marijuana market, sell it in adults-only stores that check ID, and put the proceeds in the state general fund instead of some drug dealer's pocket? Vote yes on Measure 80.
You want to legalize it? Call your congressman today. 202-224-3121. It's free, it's easy, and you don't even have to give your name, just your zip code, and they'll hook you up to your congressman. Call 202-224-3121 and tell Congress you support marijuana legalization.
Liberate your mind, liberate your
Okay, welcome back. We're going to cut here. It looks like Rick Steves is being interviewed. We'll get back over to Herb Thrasher in just a minute at the Cannabis Cafe, but Rick Steves is being interviewed down there, I-502. So, Russ, why don't we cut to your audio?
I'm sorry. Do you want me there?
Russ?
Okay, Radical Russ back here in Seattle at I-502. I'm sitting here with Kevin Oliver from Washington Normal. We're all celebrating, all happy that... I-502 has passed here. You can see in my camera that Rick Steves, the travel guru and PBS star, is being interviewed by the local, I think it's CBC, I think it's the Canadian News, is interviewing Rick Steves there. We want to remind everyone that our coverage will conclude in about 20 minutes. Top of the hour, we're going to call it a night and go celebrate ourselves. I want to thank everyone who has been involved in this, who've done such an incredible job here, starting with our crew at RoLLaJaY Studios, Brian the Red, and believe me, I do that. I run that board every day, and it's not easy. He's done a fantastic job. Big thanks to Brian the Red. Iva Cunningham and Jennifer Alexander from A Different View. Wonderful. You filled in the gaps. You filled in all the breaks and got some great coverage from our Portland studios. Thanks go out to Heather Morris and Rick Thompson and Herb Thrasher and Ico for being on the line with us and helping us understand what's going on in those locations. Karri Gallaugher out there in Denver, Colorado. Big thanks to Rudy Reyes from San Diego and Robert Platshorn from Florida calling in to give us their thoughts on marijuana election night 2012. It's a historic night, people. We have victories all across the United States. Just in case you've joined us late and you haven't heard all the stats, California's Prop 36 three strikes reform is passing with a 68% yes. Rudy Reyes for mayor of Santa California is failing with a 19%. In Michigan, Kalamazoo, 67% medical marijuana. Flint, 57% for decrim. Detroit, 65% for decrim. Grand Rapids, 60% for decrim. Ypsilanti, Michigan, 79%. For lowest priority. In the state of Oregon, Measure 80 is being called is being called a loss by the Oregonian, as well as CNN, saying Measure 80 in Oregon did not pass.
But Measure 80 is not conceding the fight yet.
In Washington State has passed. We've also gotten a passage of Colorado's Amendment 64. Marijuana will be legal for adults in Colorado and in Washington State. Arkansas's medical marijuana is still behind with 48% of the vote. We are still seeing Montana failing to overturn the bad medical marijuana law with just 41% of the vote in that state. That's our latest updates here from Marijuana Election Night 2012. Let's throw things back to our studio in Portland, Oregon.
We're actually going to throw things over to Herb Thrasher again. We had to get him cut off a little bit, unfortunately, because those Liebermeter breaks, they don't... don't take a break.
Measure 80 is not conceding the race. He's got Roy Kaufman.
We've got Roy Kaufman here from the Measure 80 campaign with Herb Thrasher there at the world famous Cannabis Cafe. And just real quick before we're done for the night, we still want to get back with the other guys, Rick and Heather. But what's your final statement of the night here for the results?
Hey guys, yeah, this is Herb Thrasher here, and we're still at the cafe, and I'm sitting here with Roy Kaufman from the Measure 80 team. And Roy, we've been hearing some numbers here, not feeling too good. How are you feeling at this point?
I think it's important to remember, Oregon's biggest city, its biggest county is right here in Portland, and that's Multnomah County. And we are trending very strong. We're picking up 58% of Multnomah County with a lot of votes still left to count. If we continue to hold strong or even pick up momentum in Multnomah County, if we pick up some momentum on the coast, it looks like we're doing that already. There's definitely still a solid chance of victory. But really, this is about, Colorado's victory and Washington's victory and the victory for the movement to end the drug war. But we're still absolutely hopeful that we'll pull out a surprise tonight.
So when we're seeing CNN and KVAL and those guys already announce Measure 80 as a loss, we're basically thinking when we see that.
Well, when I see that, I think, okay, they're eager to close that race out so they don't have one more race to track. you know, if the numbers start to change on it, then they'll come back and they'll say, it looks like the numbers are changing. We'll take the check mark off the no. You know, we see it all the time when they call something a little too soon and then they have to switch their call. But, you know, we'll see. We'll know a lot more in an hour, I hope.
I totally agree.
Well, there it is from Roy. And, you know, we're just going to keep on keeping on, guys. Optimistic here. Probably won't give you guys another update tonight. Got so much. It's been a great night here in Oregon, even though we probably might not, now that Roy's out of the room, I can say it, probably might not pass. But we're, you know, guys, we're freaking, man. Just so proud of us all. And, you know, we're just going to hold out hope, man, and keep supporting everything, this cannabis community, and all you guys. Bill, you didn't hear me say that.
Yeah, keep hope alive, you guys. Seriously, thanks so much once again. Scott Gordon, Herb Thrasher, and Michael Backer, Ico.
Take care, man. Way to go, Colorado, Washington, Arkansas, and love you guys.
Much thanks to Paul Stanford, Roy Kaufman, Bill Appel, everybody who worked on the Measure 80 campaign. You guys did an excellent job. We got it really far, and it's still not over. I'd say keep a little bit of hope in your hearts, because it could flip overnight. You could go to sleep.
And we may not win this, but that doesn't mean there isn't a change coming.
There's definitely, you know, ramifications to this vote, whether it's a win or a lose. Because even if it's a lose, it's not a huge loss at all.
We're not going down the line.
And it looks like we are getting some final results being called from CNN. In Arkansas, they're saying that the medical marijuana initiative there has lost with 48% of the votes, according to Russ. Russ, did you want to give any more updates on that?
No, that's just turning. Arkansas still behind. CNN just called it. I did want to make a mention that, you know, with, to go back to what you were saying about holding out hope for Measure 80, when I looked at what was going on with Measure 80 in the polling, I said to myself, what I want to see happen is I want to see Measure 80 do better than 44%, because that was what we got on a vote for dispensaries 2 years ago. And for me to see the vote coming out better for legalization than it came out for dispensaries tells me the people of Oregon are ready to move on from medical marijuana and move to full legalization.
Absolutely. I agree with you. That's exactly what I think we're seeing in these results here. This is not a bad day for cannabis in Oregon.
No,
there's no reason
to hang our heads. There's no reason to cry. I'm telling you, this is a good sign. This is a really good sign.
When you compare those results from the dispensary measure to legalization, there is a statement there, a clear statement that our legislature now has to consider.
Well, and here's something else to consider. This was the most liberal marijuana legalization initiative put out there.
The one that they said had no limits, with a wild, wild west. It was putting the growers in control of the entire industry. Right. And we're getting 44%, yes.
Exactly.
Now listen to that, really.
Right. And I think that is huge. And like you guys have mentioned, the fact that it's done better than the dispensaries initiative is huge.
Okay, well, definitely. We can talk more about our measure later in the week. We want to close out. We've only got a few minutes left. Let's touch bases back again with Heather, who has been waiting patiently.
In Montana,
yes?
Yes, that's right.
All right,
Montana.
Well,
and
how are the things?
Our counts are still pretty low right now. We've only got 4% of our precincts fully reported at this point, and things are still not looking good in our favor. They're a little bit better. We're at 56% are for.
And we wanted a no vote on this one.
23 and 44% are against. So, but I tell you what, no matter what, we are so excited about what we're hearing in Colorado and Washington. And no matter what, I mean, that is good for all of us. So.
That's right. It's good for all of us, and it's, you know,
it's going to be a whole new world tomorrow morning. That's all I got to say.
Really is.
Well, excellent. So, thank you so much for joining us, Heather. We're going to cut once again back to Rick in Detroit. We want to say goodbye first to Ico and Herb again, and thanks for joining us here. Rick, last minute words, you know, how are you feeling up there? Rick, you still there? Nope.
We're feeling great here. In fact, I have even a greater update to give you. Previously, Flint had been leading by 57%. Actually, with 46 of 61 precincts counted, Flint is at 75%.
Woo! Oh,
wow.
Man.
Wow. Awesome. That's great news.
And I see the mic drop the floor and walk away.
And we're looking at a real statement across the nation. Certainly, we didn't win 100% of the things nationally that we were looking to do, but we won such a significant percentage, it will be impossible for those people in power and those people that were just reelected into power to ignore the fact that the electorate that supports them, the people that they purport to represent, are overwhelmingly in support of this. Not just in the individual states that have already passed it, the 18 states that have medical marijuana, the other decrim states, but even in the hearts and minds of all Americans, even those not represented in Congress properly by the folks that support our initiatives too. I think it's impossible for anyone to look at what happened today and not recognize that marijuana as a medical substance, as a legal recreational item, is here to stay, and they should just get used to it.
Right. That's one thing that we can absolutely say is that the message is out. Everyone is talking about it. We're not that taboo subject anymore. This is a subject that does swing and influence candidates and votes. And we're not that dirty little topic that nobody wants to talk about anymore. We have come out of the closet as a nation.
When a Michael Phelps comes out, when a multiple Olympic gold medal winner comes out as a medical marijuana user, we destroy stereotypes that have been longstanding. And
you're listening to.
We're going to take a quick break, Rick. Thank you so much for your reporting from Michigan, and congratulations to you there. We'll be right back.
By the Russ Belville Show VIP members and High Times Magazine, theweedblog.com, the law offices of Omar Figueroa, the National Cannabis Coalition, MikeCan.net, California Normal, Montana Normal, and the Medical Marijuana Radio Show.
We're locking up people that take a couple of puffs of marijuana, and the next thing you know, they got 10 years. They've got mandatory sentences, and these judges just say, they throw up their hands and say, there's nothing we can do, it's mandatory sentences. We've got to take a look at what we're considering crimes.
When the Reverend Pat Robertson from television's The 700 Club...
criminalizing marijuana, criminalizing the possession of a few ounces of pot and that kind of thing, I mean, it's just...
makes more sense on the marijuana issue than the President, the Congress, and the Supreme Court.
It's costing us a fortune, and it's ruining young people. The young people go into prisons, they come out, they go in as youths, and they come out as hardened criminals, and it's not a good thing.
You know we're winning.
I think we're live now. There we go. Welcome back. You're listening to Marijuana Election Night 2010 coverage here at Radical Russ. .com.
it's been an adventure. For those of you, not listening in, or just tuning in, marijuana is legal in two states.
We got it in legal Colorado and legal in Washington. We've also got medical marijuana in Massachusetts. We've got multiple decrimentalization and lowest level priorities in Michigan.
And it's
win-win-win
beautiful.
Across the
just
board.
Beautiful,
here.
Beautiful. Thank you all for tuning in. Check out the show, RadicalRuss.com. We're live. We may not be live tomorrow because Russ is traveling around, but we're usually live 5 days a week, Monday through Friday, 3 p.m. Pacific time to 5 p.m. Pacific time. And, also we've got some great other programs, got some music shows that we have 5 days a week with replays all over the place. We got some Viper Hour, which is some old, it's the roots of marijuana music, really, old jazz and that kind of stuff, on Mondays at 8 o'clock with your host, Russ Belville. On Wednesday nights, you've got me, Red Eyes, is the nickname on that one, and that's Red Eyes Reggae Flashback with some old stuff. Love playing the old roots. and some dance hall classics for my boys. On Thursday nights, we've got Big Daddy Fink's Funky Roller Rink with the best combination of, just funk, soul, disco, hip hop, whatever he, wants to throw at you. Also on Friday nights, we cannot forget Herb Thrasher's Flower Hour, and it's a great show. They do a little bit of this, a little bit of that, a lot of rock and some sports all in the mix, and that's Fridays at 8 p.m. All of our shows are 8 p.m. And then we've also got a great talk show, Different View.
That's right. It's a Different View with Jennifer Alexander and myself, Ivor Cunningham. And basically, we just talk about the perspective that we have on ending prohibition and, cannabis as a health product, cannabis as an environmental product, and just the issues surrounding it and that sort of thing. We're on Tuesday nights, 8 o'clock Pacific, RadicalRust.com. It's a Different View. Again, you want to add anything?
Just that we're on Facebook, A Different View 420. Oh, that's right. Our Twitter is ADV420. We're on every Tuesday, 8 p.m. Pacific. Mm-hmm. We also have our videos available for download on YouTube at A Different View 420, all is one word. And
we're always looking for guests. We're always looking for topics. If you want us to cover something that's important to you,
and I just want to say that it's again, it looks like Oregon's probably not going to pass Measure 80. However, it would not be the first time in the last two elections that Oregon has called results early, and then when the finish came in because of the way that Multnomah County plays it, that it could change. So we want to keep an eye on this. But even if this is the ultimate results, we've got a lot to look forward to here in Oregon. We need to wrap up. I don't know if Russ wants to say any last words before
I think
we go.
Russ is off to celebrate. Oh,
yes,
he is
there. Back. Again, thanks to Jennifer and Iva and Brian for running the studio. They've been there for 7 hours now, and it's not easy. I appreciate all the work you guys have been doing. Mitt Romney is currently giving his concession speech, and the people here at the I-502 party are watching the Mitt Romney concession speech at this point. Coming up next on our show, I believe the Liebermaters already programmed to play the next set. If not, press Control N in Nancy, and the next set will come up. And for those of you who are new to our stream here at RadicalRust.com, this is 420 24 7365. Yeah. Turn on this stream. There will always be something on here for you.
We play
the Russ Belville show every 3 hours. We play other shows in between. Check our schedule at RadicalRust.com.
All right, we've just got about a minute left to go, and we want to thank. I want to thank you all once again. This is Brian the Red for everybody here in the RoLLaJaY Studios, for everybody who called in, everybody who's out abroad. Thank you all so much for tuning in, and just keep checking us out. We will never stop reporting on marijuana.
That's right.
Can't stop us now.
For Brian the Red and Iva Cunningham and Jennifer Alexander, Karri Gallaugher, Herb Thrasher, Ico, Heather Morris, Rick Thompson, Rudy Reyes, and Robert Platsharm, I'm
and
Radical Russ.
Thanks
for joining us, and until next time,
take care of each other, tokers.
Indeed.
What a great